We're asked to solve this absolute value inequality. If you look at the principal notes, I'm going to be using case 2 of the theorem. Thinking of the absolute value as the distance from 0, we want the distance of 0 to be less than or equal to 2. So in other words, the argument has to be in between negative 2 and 2. Then the distance will be less than 2. Once you have it set up as a compound inequality, you can just solve like normal. Okay, so here I would add 1. So negative 1 is less than or equal to 1 half x, which is less than or equal to 3. Oh, I suppose I could divide by 1 half, but I'm going to multiply everything by 2. That'll leave me with negative 2 is less than or equal to 2 times 1 half is just 1x. Less than or equal to 6. So this is telling me any number in between negative 2 and 6 should solve the original inequality. Well, 0 is in there, right? Try that. 1 half times 0 is 0. Negative 1 in absolute value is 1, and 1 is less than 2. Okay, so let's shade in all the numbers in between there on a number line. Okay, here's my number line, and this time, since there's an equal there, this is inclusive. I'm going to use a closed dot at negative 2 and a closed dot at 6. And I'm going to shade all the numbers greater than negative 2 at the same time, less than or equal to 6. Infinitely many solutions here. Let's convert that to interval notation. I'm going to use the square brackets from negative 2 to 6. The square brackets in interval notation means inclusive. 6 is actually part of the solution set.